first thing that a student sees is the looks of the campus. If it looks clean, green, smooth, well cared for, well maintained, it's attractive.
We have a survey every year. We have an outside company come in and just walk across our campus and look at things. How green is it? How pretty is it? How well does it project to a visitor? And we compare that. The same company goes around to a lot of our peer schools, does the exact same thing, and they give us a grade on it. They're walking around the campus. How many flowers do you have planted? How green is the grass? How tall is the grass? And what drives that is the question.
We've yet to realize how incredibly destructive our daily practice is, how much carbon is released into the atmosphere just from our daily or our weekly mowings, or from our $67 million worth of pesticides that go into our lawns each year. It's important to understand that 50 to 75% of the United States residential water is used solely for landscaping. Most of it simply to just water lawns.
We have these wide stretches of lawn that we mow weekly and we water and we fertilize and we want them to look beautiful. This school does it and a lot of people do it because that's what we value as a society. So Wild West is redefining the way that we have landscape. I joined Wild West pretty early on last year, and the first point of attack for Wild West was a design charrette. And a design charrette is a sped up design process. So what we did was we got together a whole bunch of students and students from other schools and professors and administrators, and then we had professional designers there, and we went through and we walked on different sites, and then we sat down and we made really rough preliminary designs from what we would do to change those sites.
And I remember staying longer than I intended. I had to just listen to some of the conversations around the landscape proposals being made. And it was a great charrette because they were not aiming to come out of there with an action plan to do X, Y, and Z, but instead to open up their thinking about what a sustainable approach to Wesleyan landscaping might look like.
It was our introduction into designing, but we still had no tangible project going on.
And so we asked them to look at the Wesco courtyard, because that's always a problem area. We needed to do something with that lawn anyway. There was a lot of problems, a lot of exposed roots, water was just running down off of it, the trees were all dying. And so we asked them to kind of step back and do a survey, give us some artist renderings of what they thought it would look like. And not only that place, but we gave them two or three other places. They came to us with actual pictures. They had taken some pictures, converted it to CAD, and then overplaced flowers on top of it and what their plantings would look like. A persimmon and ginger and all these other trees and plants. And so all of these senior level administrators were there, and the pictures were making everybody go, wow, cool, awesome. It was really, it was a complete transformation from what many of us had expected, was the typical administrative response of, very nice, we'll think about it, we'll get back to you. It wasn't that at all. It was, wow, how soon can you make this happen? How soon can you make this landscape look like this? And that culminated into Wild West picked the Wesco courtyard.
We were so excited to get the Wesco courtyard. It was a huge honor. We were also pretty scared. I mean, I know I was scared because none of us, I don't think, could have imagined at the time the amount of work that it would take.
Gentrification.
So Wild West right now is working on its first initiative, and that is to change the 1 acre of Wesco courtyard into a beautiful permaculture inspired food producing landscape.
Permaculture is a practice of observing ecological relationships that are found in nature and then mimicking those beneficial relationships to the application of design. And that's looking at the design of human systems that meet human needs while also regenerating the landscape. So it's one step beyond sustainable, it's regenerative.
If you can imagine fruit trees, and you can imagine blueberry bushes and nut trees and these edible landscapes and these beautiful rain gardens, why wouldn't we build that world that we want to be a part of, rather than just accept the fact that we're told we have to live with lawns?
Right now, this is just the sheet mulching phase where we're rebuilding the soil, essentially. We're putting compost down, and then we put a layer of cardboard down over that, and that acts as a natural weed suppressant, so you're just essentially blocking sunlight from those weeds and stopping their growth. And then we put a layer of wood chips over that. All of this soil lasagna is going to decompose over the winter, and then hopefully in the spring we'll be able to use this like nutrient-rich layer of soil to plant really productive, really healthy plant species in the spring. What students have diligently been doing is building soil and laying the foundation for what's to come next. And this is sort of like this turning point in the design process where we move into analysis. So we look at the existing conditions of the site and we say, okay, what's here? And so what? Why is it important? What does this have to do with the goals? And design marries the goals and the analysis together. The complete project is driven by the site, and design teams are focusing on design details. So one team might do a water management plan, and one team would do a planting plan, and one team would do like a longevity and wellness plan, like how is this thing going to be sustained and maintained over time. And another one is doing an implementation plan, like how much mulch do we need, and do we need to import soil, and where is the compost going, and how are we picking up compost. And there's a lot of moving parts.
Maybe we need to think about the potential distinction between performance space and social space.
So we can mix maybe some sort of border around those pathways that, as Will was saying, could help people feel like they're in more of like a secluded, like defined place.
How people feel about that terraced central social space in the I Contain Multitudes. Because that's kind of different from any of the other plans, and it wasn't mentioned in any of the comments.
Open. I totally think it should be a social space, but like I would shy away from putting it as like a place for people to perform. Like maybe somewhere for people to speak, like do public speaking or something.
The definition of beautiful and sustainable is going to evolve. It's going to change a number of times. It's not something that everybody looks at the same way. And until you get a change in the overall outlook, you're going to be fighting an uphill battle.
We've definitely had people criticize us. Right now, it looks a little bit like a war zone. There's wood chips everywhere. We can't make people believe in what we're doing, and we can't force people to become passionate about permaculture or Wild West or landscape design or environmental consciousness. We can't do that. But what we can do is show people the fact that there is a different way to have a more beautiful space that provides for us. So that means, for us, that means an edible landscape. That means a unifying space where we can all come together, a social space where we can have fun and have shows and dance around and have artwork and have music. And it's interactive and it's multifunctional and it's for us. You know, it's for the students.
Today's students are very enthusiastic about it, but what about tomorrow's students? They're going to all graduate this year. And then what?
It's like,
I do sometimes worry about, can we keep it up? Can we be committed to working on this for years? And can we inspire people every day and every new class that comes in to join us?
So somewhere, somehow, we need to change the way people look at the world. You can have a beautiful campus without mowing the lawn.
The notion of what belongs on a campus changes because of the design ideas we get. It's great to do West Coast Courtyard, but how much greater if thousands of schools said, you know, why don't we try something like that? And then if it works, expand it. That to me is a kind of activism by example. And I think that's a great thing.
You can do things differently. It takes a little more time, it takes some more man hours, but look at the long-term results that you have. You never have to mow this site again.
We're definitely gonna pull it off. And I think we're gonna pull it off really successfully, and then we'll move on to our next acre.